Okay, now we're going to go ahead and install ENB, which is fairly straightforward and simple for Fallout New Vegas. You'll go to enbdev.com, click News, and Download. Then we'll scroll down here and locate the game, which is Fallout 3 / New Vegas. And we'll download the most recent version, which is 0.267, and click this button here that says download. It shouldn't take it too long, a couple of minutes. Okay, so once it's downloaded, go ahead and extract the folders or the files to your desktop. Okay, extract, close. You should end up with these three things. We do not need this, and we're not going to bother with the injector version. We use the wrapper version of ENB. Go ahead, and again, we don't need all of these, but to make things easier on ourselves, we're just going to copy them all and worry about it later. And paste them all in here. Again, I already have these. You probably won't get that. And that is it. ENB is properly installed, and as long as you are using NVSE to load your game, it should work properly without any extra tweaks. If you are downloading an ENB preset, you would go ahead and install that now and overwrite any files that it asks you to do. Okay, there's actually one last step for getting ENB to work on New Vegas. It's actually incredibly important, and that is to turn off the anti-aliasing and MSAA multi-sampling type stuff in the video settings. So what you'll do is you'll actually launch New Vegas from the Skyrim launcher, which will bring up the options window. Select options, turn off anti-aliasing, turn off anisotropic filtering, and open advanced. You'll want to turn off transparency multi-sampling under the details tab. Make sure that depth of field is turned on, and depending on the ENB you're using, you'll probably also want to turn off water displacement. If you play in-game and you're noticing weird graphical errors in areas with lots of water, then this is probably the cause of it. So you'll want to turn that off as well. And you'll just close and click OK, and that will update your New Vegas ENE files. Now, if you are using Mod Organizer, there's one more step you have to do, because those changes won't be reflected in Mod Organizer's profiles because of the way it handles ENE files. So you'll want to go to My Documents, My Games, Fallout NV, copy the Fallout Prefs.ENE, Control C, close this, open up your Fallout New Vegas installation directory. You're going to want to find, or wherever you have Mod Organizer installed, I recommend installing Mod Organizer in the directory for the game that you are using it for. So I will go to the New Vegas installation directory, Mod Organizer, Profiles, and then we'll find the profile that we're currently working on, so Fallout Modded. And you see here is where all of the ENE files and everything for this particular profile are located. And we'll just paste it and overwrite the existing ENE file. And that is the last step for making sure that ENB is set up properly without, and you will minimize potential graphical errors that you may run into without tweaking these settings. Thank you.